Mortgage holders across the country didn't get the interest rate cut that they were hoping for today, with the Reserve Bank leaving the cash rate steady at 4.35%. And while there is some room for optimism that rates may drop in the next 6 months, Reserve Bank Governor Michelle Bullock was quick to point out that relief is unlikely before Christmas.
A day for protective gear for the Prime Minister.
Yeah. No, I'm keen.
Acutely aware of sentiment on the street.
We're constantly crunching the numbers every week. It's kind of killing us a bit.
Interest rates have doubled for us as a family of four in the last 2 years.
The Reserve Bank has kept rates on hold at 4.35% as expected.
We didn't explicitly consider an interest rate rise at this meeting.
But anticipation surrounding today wasn't so much about the decision, rather the signal sent from the RBA governor about when cuts will come.
That in the near term, it does not see interest rate cuts.
It looks like interest rates are going to stay where they are. I think to get a cut in interest rates soon, i.e. before Christmas, would probably require much higher unemployment, much lower inflation.
That's despite rates on the way down in the United States and elsewhere.
We're restrictive, but we think they're more restrictive than us. And so they're removing some of their restriction.
That we're seeing interest rates coming down in countries across the world, but not here. We are clearly at the back of the pack.
The RBA believes inflation is still sticky and wants it so it stays down.
We're not ruling out we might raise, we're not ruling out we might cut.
The Reserve Bank remains quite hawkish, which means that it's still worried about inflation.
We are making welcome and encouraging progress in the fight against inflation, and the fact that rates haven't gone up for the best part of the year now is an indicator of that.
New monthly inflation data will be out tomorrow.
There are now only potentially four more Reserve Bank meetings before the federal election, depending on when it's held. The February meeting is looking the most likely if a rate cut was to happen, and the government knows that would be influential in the election outcome.
Housing affordability is one of the main issues that I'm concerned with.
I always vote blue, and hopefully they can get back in and make some good changes for us.
The Prime Minister insists change is happening.
The message that I have is that my government is doing everything we can to put downward pressure on inflation.
A message that's on repeat, but is it resonating with voters? Ashley Raper for 10 News First.
Let's go to Ashley Raper now. And Ash, the government is clearly on the ropes. They must be hoping for a win tomorrow when those inflation figures drop.
Sandra, today didn't bring bad news, but not great news either. And the government is desperate for some good economic news, something to inject a bit of optimism in the public discussion. Labor believes, and it's being backed up by some economists, that that could come tomorrow when the monthly inflation figures are out for August. The government is hopeful its energy bill relief will have flowed through now to shift the dial on the inflation number and even put it down into the Reserve Bank's target range of between 2 and 3%. But two things on that. The headline inflation figure is the one that will be impacted when we know that it's underlying inflation that the RBA is watching. And the monthly data doesn't always give the full picture, so it isn't as crucial as the quarterly inflation data in informing the Reserve Bank's decision. Still, that won't stop the government getting excited if, in fact, inflation does come down in or near target. So something to watch tomorrow, Sandra.